Hi everybody, Alex the Pro here from Expert Forex, and in this video we are going to find great accounts to link to in our Link to Success service. And this video is going to be quite different in that I am going to show you the process that I would go to find, let's say, five accounts that I personally want to link to. So the objective of this video is educational. I want to show you the process that I use. And I'm also going to be commenting on things to avoid and things to go for in this video. So this video is aimed at traders who are considering the linking service or ones that are already linked to the linking service. It is a training video. Now on your screen, you can see the web page for the linking service, and as it says, they link to success, link your account to successful proven robots. There are about 70 accounts that you can link to, and the thing is to find the ones that are the most robust and that will generate the income that you expect to have. So let's start. So the first thing that I did was I created some linking criteria. I said, look, I want to link to profitable accounts, but they must be profitable in the last 60 days in particular. So I'm going to be looking for that. We need consistency in this account. So I want consistent weekly gains and I want consistent monthly gains. So I want low current drawdown. So I don't want to go and enter into an account that already has a big drawdown. The reason for that is that when they have a big drawdown, they can take ages to work their way out of that drawdown. And during that time, they will not enter any new trades. So you can join, but you'll be a spectator and you'll just watch this activity going on until they resolve their drawdown. And then only can you start participating when they start entering new deals. So selecting accounts with low current drawdowns and a small number of open trades is quite important. Then I'll also be looking at historic drawdowns. Obviously, you don't want to invest in an account that has huge drawdowns. Again, I'll be specifically looking at the last 60 days. And why do I say 60 days? Because these accounts are routinely reviewed and the changes are made to the settings to provide better risk control and better profitability. So the history from, let's say, 6 months ago is almost irrelevant. I'm only looking at the most recent history. And then one of the sidelines, I'd like to have a look at accounts that are tradable by using $1,000 accounts. Not an important factor, but certainly that will be the cherry on top. And then what I've created for this video is a shortlist. So the shortlist will list the account. It will say whether the account is a maybe or a no, a definite no, and I'll add comments. So I'll be adding this as we go through the process. I don't know how far we'll get. What I will do is that once this video reaches over 1 hour, I will stop the video and close it off. But I think by that time you'll have a good idea of what process to follow. Okay, so let's get straight into it. Here is the Link to Success website. I'm going to go down and you can see some really great graphs, and these are monthly graphs, so these are monthly returns that these accounts are experiencing. And here is the list of accounts, and this list is fully sortable. You can sort it and all that type of thing. And a lot of traders, what they do is they look for the monthly average gain, click on that, and they then select accounts based on that. As I say, that's not my most important criteria. My most important criteria is to look at the last 2 months of an account. So I'm not going to actually use this table as it is, but if you go down on the table like that and go down, there's 70 of these accounts. I'm hunting for the ones with the lowest drawdown currently. So here we are. To see the current status of the above linked accounts, and in particular the open trades, please use this link. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use that current status link, and it takes you to this page here. I know this page quite well, so I'm just going to go straight into linkable accounts. And what it does, it takes us to a portfolio of all the linkable accounts, and you can see the performance, close profits very high, floating loss quite low, and it has, this portfolio consists of the 70 plus accounts that we want to consider for linking. So what I then do is I go to portfolio, and here is the portfolio of all the accounts, and this is also a sortable portfolio. So the one thing that I'm going to start off with, I'm going to say I do not want to get involved in any accounts that currently have a big drawdown. And let's have a look at that. So in order to do that, I can sort on profit, floating profit and loss. So I click on that. And here you can see some of them that have got very big drawdowns. Those are the ones that I want to stay away from. So I'm going to click on there. And here are some that have even positive drawdowns. So we've got some positive drawdowns, we've got some ones that are currently resting, and we'll go and have a look at those, why they're resting, and then we have some that have got very small drawdowns, and we'll go through these accounts one by one to find the ones that meet our needs. Okay, so let's start. So this is the this account has a huge positive drawdown. Now, remember what I said about open deals. Sometimes a positive drawdown isn't a good thing because the trader is waiting for that positive drawdown to resolve itself, and for some reason, they are not closing their trade. So let's go and have a look at the first account there. It's extremely good equity that's being produced. It has doubled. All of these accounts have started with a $10,000 account, so this one has more than doubled its account. So let's go and have a look at it. Click on that, and then the FX Blue opens an analysis of that particular account, and here we can see the account has a $10,000 profit. It has a 2,800 open deal gain, and the equity is 23,000, which gives basically that 130% gain that they're showing there. Now, the only problem here is that the time period is wrong. There's 142 days. If you look at the actual chart, it was dormant for a long time, so it only really started trading at that point, which was in October. The 4th of October. So the October, November, and the start of December, this account is exactly 2 months old. So that it caters, and this is the section that we want to look at, and that's where the magnificent growth happened. And part of this account's the plus of this account is that it has a 100% win ratio, trades the euro USD. And let's have a look, should we invest in this account? So the first thing that I do is I change this chart to say, show me the equity chart. So what will happen is it will actually show drawdowns, that the red line, when it's below the blue line, that's a drawdown. And when it's above the blue line, it's actually a positive open trade situation. So, and I'm not too worried about the state before then. So it looks like this account was used for something else before then, but it has been used correctly from October. And there you see it's mainly positive drawdown, then small. So drawdown in this account's case is not a factor. We don't have to worry about drawdown. If anything, it has a positive drawdown. And I'm just looking at my criteria. It's obviously positive, so it's positive. It has a positive drawdown. Let's have a look at the weekly consistency. So what I do there is I look at the weekly returns. And again, I just ignore what happened before. And here you see the weekly returns quite nice. Some weeks were 18%, 4%, 24%. and so on and so on. So really good weekly returns. If we look at the monthly returns, we see some nice monthly returns, 52% in 1 month, 30% in the other month. So this is definitely an account to consider for the shortlist. Now, the only thing that worries me about this account is the open trades. Although they are positive, it worries me, firstly, why is this trader not cashing in their positive trades? I'm not sure if they're trying to protect this win, this 100% win ratio. I'm not sure if that is happening, but why is this trader not cashing in? So let's have a look at those open deals. So in order to have a closer look at, remember it's 2.8, and we look at that, and here we have it, and let's see, there are 31 open trades. Most of them are very nicely positive. They're all trading the euro USD, and they're all using 0.1 of a lot. Now that answers another criteria that I have. You could easily trade this with a $1,000 account, because all you do is you use 0.01 lots. And when you link your account, there's a sender, which is this trader, that sends the signals to the receiver EAs, which you then have. And then in the receiver EA, you can just say, my personal lot CR sizing shouldn't be 0.1, but 0.01. So 10% of the lot sizing that the trader is using. Okay, so there we go. So we've gained a lot of information here. Let's go and see the negative deals that are open. So most of them have nice positive trades. Let's go and have a look at the negative deals, how many there are. And here we are. So we see there's very few negative deals. In fact, there they are. They don't amount much in terms of. So the two questions I really have is, why does the trader not just close all the deals right now? Just close them all and start all over again, or at least close all the positive deals and have a small little drawdown that is being carried. But certainly this is going to go on my shortlist. So let's go to the shortlist. So here we go, link 300 SM. We say yes, we want, and I'll just make that a small number so it doesn't squeeze everything out. Yes, we definitely a maybe, and we want to say open a deal concern. So as I said, this is a short list. I'm not going to try and resolve that open deal concern, but certainly it meets all the other criteria that we're looking for. Okay, so we've looked at that one. That one looks like it's going to be a more or less the same. It has a big floating profit and loss, and it is not as profitable as the other one, but let's go and have a look at that particular one. So we click on that, and here we are, and the same situation. This one started in early October, so we've only got 2 months of history here. It's made a 60% return, which means it's about an average of 30% a month. Let's start with our equity. And again, we ignore all the ones before October. That's about there. And you'll see the equity is actually very, very few drawdowns. That's the only drawdown. So it's, drawdown isn't a problem here. Again, let's have a look at the weekly return. And also nice and positive, some really good 8%, 9% there, 9%. 6% and so on. So the returns are, the weekly returns are very good. And let's have a look at the monthly returns, also very nice, 11% and 26%. So again, this is a definite maybe. And we'll have a look at the orders again. These are open orders, and the trader is trading exactly the same currency. Also very successful there, has a few, and I'll just sort them. And it only has four accounts that are four trades that are negative at this stage. And again, I ask the question, why doesn't the trader just close all the deals right now, or at least close the positive deals and start again? So that's my only concern about this particular account. And again, let's go and list it on the in the shortlist. So it's link 100 SM.
One of these would be good at, just make sure at that level, and we say that's a definite maybe. And we've got the same thing here, open deal concern.
All right, so we've only really looked at one type of account so far, but let's move on. As I say, this is like a workshop, this one, and we'll now go straight. There's nothing more, much more to look at, so we'll go to the next account. To do that, I'll just do the back arrow, and it'll take us to the linked accounts. Okay, so the next account, I suspect, is going to be more or less the same. You can see there's a positive open deals, and let's just go and have a look at it very briefly. And there we are. It's also trading the Euro USD, and I'll just have a look at the open deals. And there we have a few open deals that really don't amount to much, and that again begs the question, why not just close them all and start again? The one reason why that might be a worry is that this 100% record might be compromised, but I would rather have safety than compromising and compromise the 100% than just sit around with a whole lot of open deals. Again, the positive deals can be closed and the negative ones can float around. So we do the same again.
Link to 100 SM, and that's a definite maybe. And we have our open deal consent.
So as we've seen, the focus there is very much on the Euro. So you would not select all three of those accounts. You would select the ones that you see as the most that's got the good best balance between profitability and drawdown and risk. So let's move on to the next account. Okay, so we've done the first three there with big positive drawdowns. Now we get a couple of accounts that have, so let's say, normal drawdown. So let's kind of have a look at that. So we're going to look at link 3P. Now link 3P is a very old account. It's 729 days. You can see it's had periods of no growth. Those are the times when it's battled with drawdowns. In fact, let's put the equity on there and you'll see that. So those straight periods are drawdown periods. The drawdowns haven't been extremely big, so they're not so much of a concern. But recently, the growth has been pretty good. Let's have a look at the weekly growth. Now, this might be problematic because we're covering such a long period. And here you can see the weekly growth. There's 1.2, 1.6, 1.1. And then there was a negative week and so on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to disregard this particular one. Firstly, the weekly growth doesn't look really great. Let's kind of have a look at the monthly one. Yeah, we're looking at minus 2, 4, 1.5. Not really great figures for what we're looking for. So linked 3P is not going to be a goer. So let's update our shortlist. So that was link 3P, and we're not going to waste any time on that. That's a definite no. And low profitability. Okay, so let's move on to the next account. Right, so here we are, and here we have link 2P. Now, I suspect that's going to be the same situation. Although these accounts have doubled themselves, let's go and look at that anyway. So now we know what to look for, and there you can see a very big period of no action. And certainly the most recent time doesn't look good, so I'm not even going to waste time on this one. I can already tell that the weekly numbers are bad. Let's get out of here. All of the profits were made at the launch of this particular account and nothing further. So let's go to the next account. So let's list this for next week. We know not to go to this particular account. And it is low profitability. Okay, so after a while things start repeating themselves, but that's all good. There will be some new developments as we go through the various strategies that are listed on the linked accounts. Okay, so now we get to an account called Link PR4, and let's go and see what that one's up to. Okay, Link PR4's got a nice growth at the end there. So what's happened, it's got cleaned out, and from the beginning of October, that was one of the review days, it has grown very nicely. Let's go and have a look how much the growth, however, has been. So we look at that, and we 1.3, 1.2, not really great growth. And let's go and look at the monthly return. Again, 5-1, not the greatest growth that we're looking for. Let's just go back to the drawdown situation there. Drawdown's really good on this one. It's a very little drawdown there. That doesn't look like a problem. But the profitability is low. So what we'll do is we'll note that on our shortlist. No at the moment. Low profits and low drawdown. So there is potential for this one, but we'll have to look at it later on. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so now we get to a type of account which is a account with a 1K before it. So what that means is that although the account that is being used by the trader is a $10,000 account, we are trading it as if it's a $1,000 account. And the reason is that it's very difficult to get demo accounts that do not expire that have a $1,000 account. Okay, so let's go and have a look at that particular one. Okay, so the first observation, it's a 256 day old account. It's gone through some rough patches over here. Let's go put the equity on and just to see those rough patches. Oh, didn't work very well. When it doesn't show the equity, it means it doesn't have sufficient history to provide drawdown information, which is a bit of a limitation, but we'll get around that. And let's have a look now. Remember, when you see a 7%, which is also wrong because the equity has actually gone up 10%, so it's actually gone up 100% if you take it to be a $1,000 account. So it's doing quite well. So let's go and have a look at the weekly returns, because that will give us an idea of what's going on here. Okay, now we have to multiply the weekly returns by 10 to equate to a proper return on $1,000. So let's have a look here. So it's 0.03, 0.1. So that's like 1%, that's 3%, that's 3%, very low profitability. So this is quite low profitability, and maybe not the kind of profitability that we're looking for. So again, quick decision. Okay, very good, and we then move on to the next one. So I think you're getting an idea of the process, but we need to work through this process quite a lot, because there are different strategies that we need to look at. That was 1.7C, and then we got 1.75C, so it's just one more. Let's kind of have a look at that one. And now we know what to look for. So the first thing we're going to look at is the weekly profitability. If that's not high, we just pass this one. All right, so it's stop trading, which is some of the EAs do have a phase where if they do not see a tradable link, they will stop trading, which is a good position, a good place to be, because then there's no open trades like in this particular case. So the open, so this account has made 100% return, because it's $100,000 account over 2 days. So let's go and have a look again at the weekly returns. After a while, you work out what to look out quickly. Now this one looks a little bit better, so let's go and read. All right, so that's a 3% return, that's a 4%, that's 3%, 2% return, 5%, 5%. So the recent profitability actually doesn't look too bad for this particular one. And let's have a look at the monthly profitability. Okay, much better. So we're looking at that's actually 12% return, that's 16% return, and December is a little bit too short, and before that was a 14. So this is an account that is worth looking at. It has no open trades, it's had a nice recent profitability, is nice and strong, and I think we're going to really put this one on our maybe list. The thing we didn't look at is the drawdown. Let's just kind of have a look at the drawdown. This is the one where no drawdown, floating profit and loss. Oh, there we are. There we have some drawdown information. And we can see that the drawdown at the most was 36%, because that's we're talking about a $1,000 account. Not too bad. It seems to be under control. It was very bad in before, and it's been managed nicely, so not going to be a problem. So let's go on to the next account. Right, so the next accounts do not have any open trades, and that is very similar to the one we've just looked at. You can see historically it had a balance, but when we actually looked at it, it didn't have a balance, so that's interesting. But these ones are nicely profitable if you look at them from the $1,000 account perspective. So let's move on to 156C, and we'll have a quick look at that one. And you can see how I start short-circuiting the evaluation one once I learn more or less what the trade is all about. And here we are, it's closed. Nice steady growth, very nice steady growth. Aussie, New Zealand, again, no USD or yen involved in this trading, and we'll have a look at the weekly returns. What is that? 2%, 1%, 1% could be a little bit low. 3%, 2%, it's tending to be a little bit low. Let's just see monthly return. That's a 6% return, that's a 7% return, and so on. Let's have a look at the drawdowns. Oof, had a big one here. That was in July, and then since then virtually no drawdown. So what's happened is this account is most probably over controlled, so it's giving slow profits but also very low drawdowns. So one can consider an account like this by actually saying, I want to increase the lots that are being traded, because this account is nicely profitable, not highly profitable, but nicely profitable with very low lot sizing. I'll go for more lot sizing. I'll increase the lot sizing by 50% because it is such a safe account. So let's put that on our short list, and I'll call it a maybe account. And we need to further investigate that. So we've got quite a few on our maybe list, and we've got a few that we completely straight away ignored. And let's go to the next one. Okay, now we're on to 170C. It has no open trade, so we look at that. Also nice steady growth. Let's see if this one's got any drawdowns. I'll just put the equity on first. Nothing major. You can see there's nothing major. So nicely controlled account. Let's go and have a look at the weekly returns. That's 2%, 2%, 3%, 1%, 1%. So not great returns. But again, the drawdowns are actually exceptionally low. And then we look at the monthly returns. And we say, okay, oops, that's 11%, that's 11%, that's a 7%. So the returns are actually quite good. I'm going to put this on the maybe list, and let's do that. Okay, now we're moving to 171C. Could be very similar. Let's go and have a look. I think it's dangerous to make too many assumptions in that area. Some might actually surprise you. So now there we saw that it had a minus, but this one's showing, because FX Blue is sometimes slightly out of sync. But again, a beautiful growth curve, slightly different currency, Aussie CAD. It's Aussie CAD, I know, is a slightly low volatile currency. So that's 3%, 2%, 1%, 6%. So reasonable profitability. Let's look at the monthly. Good, that's 13% there, that's 10% there, and in December it's already done 3%. So again, same profile, different currency, definitely a maybe on this particular one. And we'll just do that, we'll just add it to the maybe list. So I'm giving some little clues as to the kind of things that I think about when I'm evaluating a trading statement. So let's go back to the list. So the next one is 173C, and away we go with that one. Now, as you can see, this process can be very boring. Again, here's an example of a trader changing the settings and it having a very positive impact on the results. Let's just see when this started. This started in September, so these results are really, really good. And I guess if we have a look at the weekly returns, again, look at this. All the weeks are positive. That's a 6% return, 5%. Oh, this is a really good one. 8% return, so on. And then let's look at the monthly returns. 17%, 23%. Oh, we found a gem here. No need to go any further. Let's just go and have, just make a definite, let's see if we can, oh yeah, this one doesn't have enough history to show the drawdowns. Let's just have a look. But I think this is sufficiently robust to go with. So this might not even be a maybe. This might be one of the certainties. And we go 1K link 173C. And we have a maybe. And we say good profitability. Sometimes a trader gets that sweet spot, and this one looks like it has hit the sweet spot. Okay, let's go back to the list. Okay, so now we get to a new type of account. This one trades Martingale, so it's linked 192M, and let's go and have a look at what that one does. So this one's traded on a $10,000 account, so we don't need to make any adjustments. It uses the Aussie New Zealand, which is a pretty low volatile currency, and it has produced 44% return over a 60-day period. So the period fits in good, well, the return is fantastic. Let's see if we can get drawdown statistics on this one. This equity will do for now. Okay, so there we go. There's some drawdown here. From 12,000 down to 7,000. That's almost a 5,000 drawdown. 50% drawdown. So this is a case of high risk, high return. So it's produced a 44% return, but it's had a 50% drawdown. So here is where you need to make your decision. What you can do is you do the opposite to what we did with the previous accounts, is instead of trading 100% of what this trade is using, you can use 50% of what this trade is using. So then you can go for a 22% return, but your drawdown will be reduced to 25%. So let's have a look at the weekly returns. These are the weekly returns. So that's a 7% return, a 2%, 1%, 1%. Basically, let's rather look at the monthly. It will give us a better feel. But they're all positive. And here we go. So there's a 13% return and a 16% return. And in December already, and it's only the 4th, there's been an 8% return and there are no open deals. So profitability is really good on this one. And this might become a definite maybe. Okay, so we've listed that one. And in fact, we could take one of those accounts as a definite. I'm not sure. I'm just going to mark this one. But if that's not the one, we can look at the other. So what we've got is we've got a one definite there using a particular method that goes for 100% success. Here we've got one that I think just trades normally and achieves really good. And here we have a Martingale. So we identifying a mixture of strategies that spreads our risk. But we're starting to find some nice gems here. Let's continue the process. It is a laborious process. It's one that you need to do. You can do it in the evenings. You can do it over weekends. You don't need to do it while the market's open. And once you've done it, you know what to avoid and which ones to keep a good eye on. But I think the importance here is that we are using the current drawdowns as our starting point, because that's one of the biggest problems of the linking service. People go and join accounts that have huge drawdowns. Now I look forward to your feedback on how you've experienced the process so far and whether it has helped you with the selection of your linked accounts. In the next section, I'm sure we will find some really good accounts to link to using exactly the process that we're using right now. As always, links to items mentioned in this video will be in the description of the video as well as in the commentary of the video. So from me, Alex Deploy, cheerio.